Hello, in this video I will show you how to extract the elevations of profile of bus in Google Earth to Excel or even to draw it in AutoCAD. The main idea is that I have done a macro that can use it to export the elevations to an Excel or even to draw the exact profile in AutoCAD. But first I have to do some steps before use it. And I will tell you how to use it in this video. So first I will open the bus in Google Earth and then show elevation profile of it. I will just make a print screen of it, and then I will make a new image. Edit, paste. I will only crop the profile, I don't care about anything else. Okay, copy, let's save. Okay, edit, paste. All right, okay, save. I will open a new drawing file in AutoCAD. I will copy the image at it, Control C and then Control V. I will choose any insertion point and in scale it doesn't matter, and angle 0. Okay, here is the profile of my bus. So to use the macro, first I have to do some steps in AutoCAD and then use it. And even for these people who doesn't know the macro, macro is something like if you use the programming setting in AutoCAD, but you don't have to program. I just done the macro and I will show you how to use it. Okay, and here is small tips. That if you use the version of 2010 or lower, you have the macro will be built in the AutoCAD. Okay, but for the higher versions, you have to download it first and set up it afterwards. Okay, and how you can get the download link for your version? Simply, if you type VBA run, for example, that's the square that you have to see. But if you don't have the macro, okay, if you don't have the macro built in your version, you will another square will appear, the square that tell you that you don't have the macro options in your AutoCAD version and you have to download it first. And he will type for you the download link that you just will press on it and will show you all the versions, all the available versions, and will choose the right one for you. And simply will just download it. It's about 100 mega and then set up it very easily and it will be built in your AutoCAD. Okay, so let's see what we have to do first before we use our macro. I have to just make a new layer. You don't have to make a new layer, but it's easily for me, nothing more. But what you have to do is that you have to draw the ground line. I will just move exactly on the ground line of the picture. Of course it will not take more than minute from you. Okay, and even I have choose a long bus. Okay, all right, okay, here is the ground line. Then the second step that I have to draw the datum line. Okay. And copy it for the known elevation. Here what I have known, that 170. Okay. And then I will draw a line at any station. Of course, supposed to be known. Here I draw line at station 2.5 kilometer, and then I will draw line at 5 kilometer. Okay, I will just move it to show it for you. That's what I have done. Okay, what the next step that I will convert the convert my drawing objects to a real one. How will that be? If we measured this station, supposed to be 2,500 kilometer, and here the length is not equal. So what will I do? That I will draw a line with 2,500 meters. Okay. And I will use a line comment. Sorry, a line. I will select my object and I will choose first point and here first point, second point. Sorry. Here is the first point and here is the second point. Okay, I will press enter. Yes, so that exactly will be exact the same. So the horizontal distance is the exact as the real one, but the vertical distance, let's check it. We will measure it. It's not the same. It's about 300, but the real distance, if we see here, the real distance is about 8 meters. Okay, so the vertical distance here is drawn with a scale, with the scale as shown. Okay, so my macro gives you two options. First option, if you wanted to draw the exact profile in AutoCAD, and second option, if you wanted to export it to an Excel file. But first, you have to do something, but it's very important. You have to check that the begin of the ground line is the same as the begin of your datum line. Okay. Okay, the second step that I have to make a point at the beginning of the my datum line. I have created the point at the beginning of my datum line. I will just keep the just make sure that the end of my ground line is the exact of the end of my datum line. Okay, I'll just delete it. So the horizontal distance here is the length of my datum line. Okay, I will just copy it and I will just keep it. Okay, so it's about 14,500 meters. Okay, I will just delete all the lines, but I will keep only the ground line. So I then load my macro by type app load, and I will select it and load it. Okay, and then run it by type VBA run, and then run it. Okay, Okay, here the first message is tell user to select object. I will select my ground line. Second message that tell you that you have to select the first point of your datum line, which is this point. Okay, then enter the datum value. The datum value here was 162. Okay, 162. And then enter the vertical scale. We have calculated. Okay, I will copy it and then paste. Enter the station distance. The distance between your stations. I will make station at every 50 meters. Enter the horizontal distance that we have told you about. I will just copy it and then paste. Okay. Here I give you the option. If you wanted to draw the exact profile with your scale in the CAD or not. Let's see how we can do it. So I will type Y to draw it. If you type N, he will just cancel it. Okay, I will type yes. Okay, here I give you the option to choose your horizontal scale and vertical scale. First, for your horizontal scale, I tell you here that for 1 unit at CAD, how long is the distance in meter? That means that if I draw 1 unit in CAD, like if you just want to do that 1 unit in CAD express 1 meters, so you will type 1. If you just want to do that 1 unit in CAD represent 2 meters, you will have to write 2 and so on. If you want that 1 unit express 0.1 meters, you have just type 0.1 meter and so on. So here I just want to 1 unit express 1 meter. Okay, and for the vertical scale the same idea, but as usual the vertical scale is about 0.1. that means 10 times of your horizontal scale. Okay, so enter and then position of your modified profile. I will just want to draw profile here and here we go, draw it. Station elevation 0 and elevation for every station. Okay, and so on. So the second option, if you want to export it to an Excel file, yes, I want to it, yes. And here I tell you where is the bus you want to save it. I just like I want to save it here. I will just copy it and paste it here. Okay, enter. A message tell you that points have been exported to this bus that you have chosen and with this file stations and elevation.csv. Let's check it. And here we are. Yes. Station space elevation. If you want to convert it to more than one column, select it and from data here, text to columns, separated by delimited, the next, choose space, and the next, finish, and here we are, station and the exact elevation of it. Let's check it for 0 to 180, and here for 0 of course 285.2. Okay, exact. So for this macro I will just put my email in the description of the video, and if you want the macro you have to just contact me and I will send it for you. Okay, and thank you.